Later that night, around a warming fire, I show Anu the Book of Lost Horizon by Hilton. The book that was inspired by the very mountain and valley that I'm now camped in. This book, Anu, can you see? Maybe put it in the light. It's called Lost Horizon. And I read it. Yeah, I read. This is the mountain. This is the snow mountain. And I read it a long time ago. And the story is of some people finding themselves lost in the valley and going to the monastery, which is just below this beautiful, beautiful mountain. For a long time, I thought it was just a book, a story. Didn't know that there was a real snow mountain. Didn't know it existed until very recently. And so I thought I would come and see if it would be my heaven on earth. Is that good?
Kojichi.
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 Very good.
Kojichi. Kojichi.
Oh. Thank you for coming here. You found
the
place.
I think I have.
He's very happy that you made all the way to here from very far away.
I'm very happy too.
My big old one, so sad.
It's early the next day. All I could think about through the night was, would the clouds lift in the morning? It's my last chance to see Shangri-La, the perfect snow-capped mountain of Kawakapo and its little valley. It's been a long journey for me traveling across China and Tibet, and a very long wait to finally see if my dream can ever come true.
Oh, wow. Fantastic. I am without words, it's so beautiful. This is my Shangri-La.
The little valley down there is just how I imagined it in the book, exactly like that. And then these great mountains surrounded it, which are very lush and fertile. A river running down and then going up and up to this beautiful, beautiful, unbelievable cone of snow which changes in the light as the sun hits it, and then it disappears again in the clouds. Coming through the clouds, you can just see this wonderful, amazing light and the clouds shifting and this cone just rising up above. So hard to explain that I feel very calm inside, which is very unusual for me. I've also felt that I've achieved things that I never thought I would achieve at this stage of my life. I've overcome certain fears, and that's been wonderfully uplifting, and I feel quite brave, very chuffed with myself. for the things I've taken on, and I feel that I've grown quite a lot in this whole thing. I feel very, very happy. I can't tell you how happy I feel. I think this place is absolutely beautiful. I think it is heaven on earth, and I think I'm very, very grateful to have had the privilege to have come here, and being able to look at this beauty, which I thought just was in a book, and I see why they worship it and why it does sort of have a huge effect on you, an amazing effect. It's the peace and the beauty of it all. And I suppose that it's no surprise that it's become such a sacred mountain for people because of its colossal beauty. I suppose that's what I'll call paradise on earth. My Shangri-La.